Today we're gonna learn how to properly use contour lines in Revit. Hey everyone, Oded here from Arc Intelligence. Today we're diving into two powerful tools from the Environment for Revit plugin, Set Elevation and Check Elevation. These tools streamline the process of creating accurate topographic models within Revit. Landscape architects and site planners often work with contour lines to represent elevation changes. Environment for Revit lets you use a similar approach, making your workflow more intuitive. Let's start with set elevation. I have some model lines drawn, each representing a desired elevation, but they're currently at zero elevation or sea level. To fix this, go to the Environment tab, then Model Lines panel, and click Set Elevation. After clicking, you'll see the options bar appear, which lets you set your preferences for how the tool will function. Let's go through the different preferences in the options bar. Use check elevation symbol. This checkbox allows you to add elevation labels to your model lines as you set their elevations. Text type. This drop-down menu lets you choose the type of the text that will be used for the check elevation labels mentioned before. Elevation. In this text box, you can choose the desired start elevation of the set of model lines you wish to set. Increment. This text box allows you to set the fixed increment value that will be added to the elevation of each subsequent line you click. For example, if you set the increments to 50 cm, then clicking each line will increase its elevation by 50 cm. Elevation base. This drop-down menu allows you to choose the reference point from which the elevation of your line will be measured. Here are your options. Internal origin, this is the default Revit origin point, the 000 in your project. Survey point, project base point, or level. You can choose any existing level in your Revit project as the elevation base. This is useful if you have level corresponds to a real-world elevation, like in my case, the sea level. Next we have the override color. This button allows you to change the color of the model lines that have been modified using the set elevation tool. This can be helpful for visually distinguishing modified lines from unmodified lines. This will only change in the current view. We'll set our starting elevation, let's say 10 meters, and an increment of 50 centimeters. Now, each line I click will have its elevation adjusted, clearly visualized in the 3D view. Also notice the lines that change their colors and these labels added. These labels are actually native Revit text nodes, but they behave like smart objects in a way. When you added elevation value in one of these labels, the elevation of the reference model line is automatically updated to match the new value. This makes it a very efficient way to ensure the accuracy of your model lines and their elevations. You can also use this tool to bulk modify lines' elevations. Simply click outside a line, then cross multiple lines and click again to edit them all at once. Next, check elevations. The check elevation adds smart text nodes to model lines, showing their elevation. These are practically the same labels we have seen in the previous tool. This is great for double checking your work. Simply click on the Environment tab, then navigate to the Model Lines panel and select the Check Elevation tool. Once you've chosen the tool, you'll see the options bar populated with relevant settings. To keep the text readable and always oriented to view and never upside down, check this Keep Readable box. The text style. This drop-down menu allows you to select the desired text type for your elevations label. Elevation base. As with the set elevation tools, the elevation base setting here determines the reference point from which the elevation of your model lines is measured. The available options are identical: internal origin, survey point, project base point, or any level you have in your Revit model. Then simply click on the lines to add the notes. As mentioned before, if you change the elevation value in a note, the linked model line updates automatically. Just like the set elevation tool, you can add bulk elevation labels by crossing the desired lines. This Environment for Revit tools offer flexibility workflows for creating precise and beautiful landscape models. And importantly, once you've set your elevations, you can use them to create topo surfaces or topo solids for an accurate BIM model. These 3D topographies are the essential part for representation and scheduling. Thanks for watching. If you find this helpful, please like and subscribe for more Environment for Revit tutorials and workflows.